Hello, welcome back. I am Chris Menard. Great Excel video today. I was looking at my YouTube data, and YouTube has this cool feature where you can go look at a lot of data and you can do period over period or year over year. And if you've followed my channel, you know how much I love year over year analysis. So I have my actual YouTube data up from March 2017 through April of 2022. We're going to do pivot tables. We're going to look at year over year. We're going to look at period over period. We're going to do some percentages. We're going to make percentages in a red font. A lot of stuff to do. And in case you're wondering, if you say, Chris, I don't care about YouTube, you would do this for your company. You could track revenue. You could track expenses. You could track net income or profit. So it just has to be something numeric. I'm actually going to pick on that column C, my watch time in hours, but that could be revenue for you. So this is part of my Watch Chris work, because I actually wanted to figure this out. YouTube gave me what I wanted, but for just 1 year compared to another year, looking at each month, I want to see all the years, and I got multiple years of data. So let's do this. Insert tab, pivot table. I'm going to put it on a new worksheet, hit OK. There are all my fields. When I'm running through here, I may give you some tips that I have said before, but I believe they're going to be worth repeating. You know that that date field and the header rows came in here. I'm going to pop back here just for a second. If you look up at that date, 3-1, May 1, it's month, day, and year. So when I drop that date field into the rows area, Excel is going to give me every year, but then I can expand it and see the quarter and then see the month. So let's do that. Now this is not what I want, but just to prove it did exactly what I just said, if I right click one of these years and say expand and collapse, and I'm going to hit expand every field, and one more time, should have done it all. There you go. You can see it's doing year, quarter, and month, but I don't want that in this example. So undo, 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 undo. Cool tip. You may have caught it. If you drag the date down to the rows, it did exactly what I just said. Do an undo right here. Control and the letter Z. Now I've got every month and every year running down column A. Perfect. In case you're wondering, what if I don't remember Control Z? Click on a date, which I've done in column A. Go to Pivot Table Analyze, and you would hit Ungroup. So you're back with me now, and then hit Group Selection. I'm going to pick years, and I'm going to pick months. I don't want to see the quarters. It picks up the first date. It picks up the last date. Click OK. There we go. You may be tempted right now to say, Chris, I'm going to take these years and stick them up here in the columns. And I said I wanted to see watch time. So here's watch time. Again, if you're a company, this would be your revenue or net income or something. This is great if I just want to look at the numbers, but this is not going to help me with my year over year analysis or period over period. So I'm going to simply take the years and put them back here. And here we go. All these numbers are great. The numbers that are in bold are called subtotals. Subtotals show up at the top of the group. If you don't like it, go to Design tab at the top, subtotals, and you can turn off the subtotals. You can put the subtotals at the top where they were, or you could even put them at the bottom. I'm gonna just leave them off. Okay. There are your subtotals. Now, I want to figure out first year over year analysis by month. So what that means is I'm comparing April of 2017 to April of 2018, June of 2019 to June of 2020. So the same month, but different years. So I'm going to take watch time again and drag it in here. So I've got watch time twice. By the way, these numbers are driving me crazy. I'm going to right click in column B and hit number format. And I'm going to make them number. I don't need any decimals, but I do want to see 1,000. And I'm going to use this negative thing here. Nothing should be negative, though. That's perfect. Same thing here. I'm going to go ahead and format the numbers real quick. There we go. So I've got the exact same numbers twice. So here we go. Right click. I'm in column C. Right click. Go to show value as, and I want to do a difference from. I'm going to do a difference from the year, and it is going to be previous. When I click on OK, that very first year, there's nothing to compare it to. So that is why everything in C5 to C14 is blank. And if you notice, I got a number 744 there. So what this is saying right here is for the month of March 2018 compared to March of 2017, it went up 744. There is some rounding going on there. If you want to check this real quick, which I would do, I'm going to take 744 plus 550. And now I just want to say, does this number equal that number? Again, it's the rounding. I better get the answer true. And I do. Okay. So those are correct. So I'm saying that March 2018 went up 744 watch hours compared to March of the previous year. And then look, it keeps on going. March of 2019, 2020. And there's why I did the negative numbers. Took a big hit in April. In April of 2021, my watch time went down significantly. Can anyone tell me why? I don't expect you to know this, but remember COVID hit in March of 2020, around mid-March. A lot of people went home, and I remember going home and never coming back into the office. I took my laptop home, and people were watching my Zoom videos in March and in April of 2020. That's still the highest watch time I think I've ever gotten. So pretty cool. Keep going. So now that was the year over year. Let's do period over period. Month over month would be another name for this. So here we go again. Watch time in here. Right click. I'm going to fix the numbers in just a second. Difference from, in case you're wondering, this is exactly what I just did. Except this time it is going to be the word month, and it's still going to be previous. So I should have data here in column D. Let me go fix this formatting real quick. Number format, number, no decimals. Yeah, negatives here also. In March of 17, I did 550. In April, we went down 56. To 464. Perfect. In case you're wondering, it is correct that January is empty here because January is starting the year for me. If I wanted to see December to January going across the years, I could come back here and add a helper column in my YouTube data here if I wanted to do that. But I'm happy right now. One more. I love percentages. We've already done year over year in column C, and something else I would do if I was really doing this, year over year and period over period. If you wanted to call this month over month, you could. By the way, exactly what YouTube was trying to help me do, but YouTube would not have done all the years, year over year, period over period. Here we go, last one, and then I'm gonna do a cool trick with percentages. One more time with the watch time. Right click. This one is slightly different. Show value as, we have been doing difference from, but this time it is gonna be percentage difference from. Click that once. I do wanna go year over year, so years, previous. I believe Excel is going to give me a percentage automatically because it's percentage difference from. Let's see if I'm right. Perfect. There you go. So that 744 going from March of 1 year to March of the previous year is 135% increase. If you don't mind, I'm going to test that real quick. Plus 550 times 1.3519. Yep, there you go. It's working. Okay. Now, here's what I don't like. I love percentages because this is really what I wanted to see. I wanted to see it all, but I really want to see these percentages, but I want to see some negatives. So again, right click, and if I go to number format, here's the issue. I do want to see two decimal places because I'm looking at percentages, but I want to see the negative percentages. I am making this up in parenth. So I go to custom. The first cell you got selected is the cell that's your sample. If you notice, I got 0.00 percentage. That is what's going to happen with positive numbers. I'm going to put in a semicolon and then type how I want negative numbers to look. So a semicolon first. Can't recall if that was it. And then put in my negative numbers. Open parenth 0.00%, close, hit OK, scroll down, because I do have some negatives. Yes, if you see a number in red in column C, you should see a percentage in parenth in column E. I want those percentages that are negative to show up in a red font. Can I do that? Absolutely. Here's another tip for you. Again, right click, number format. Custom's already selected. Click in that box, open bracket. I want them in a red font color, R-E-D, close bracket. Hit OK, and now they are showing up as negative numbers. One more time on that April, you can see that was a significant drop. COVID, people watching Zoom videos, April of next year, people have got Zoom figured out basically. So that explains that to me, why that happened. Not a problem. I really appreciate your time. I know this was a long video. I hope this is helpful for you, these videos. Watch Chris work. Feel free to subscribe. Feel free to ring the bell. If you have any comments or questions, please put them down in the comment section. Have a great day. Thank you.